Start a warm-up in a second. This is the club. So here I'm doing these intros. I don't know who's watching. So if you're in the class, you know what it is. If you're not, this is our black sash class. People that have been training for at least 3 years, usually. And it's more advanced. We move at a faster pace, and we're somewhat into the year. It's a year-long unit. So this is not the first class that anyone would ever take or see. But, you know, do what you like. So let's start our warm-up. Sink and shift to the right. Sink and shift. Switch. We are going to continue pushing forward in the 38. We are also going to start the Saber form this week. So, Saber form is one of two weapons forms required for second degree and inside. I won't talk about the warm up too much. Today I might go back and review some of the details later. For now, let's just do our warm-up. The Chen saber is a little different. If you have a solid saber that doesn't flex, the Chen saber has some flex to it, and it's used to get loud noises to happen, basically, when you do the form correctly and shoot power through the sword in the right way. It will vibrate and make a loud sound. And switch. So you can practice with a wooden or a rigid saber, but eventually you'll probably want to get the spring steel. Flimsy doesn't sound good, but kind of that kind of saber. I'll show an example. Left foot forward. We will continue through 38 though. Inhale when you come back, exhale when you walk. Switch. Inhale. Let the feet adjust as you sink and shift your weight. And release. Chan Si Jing. Take the right hand. Go left. Here. Inhale. Exhale. without me seeing people needing more help with moves. So like other classes, what we're going to try is if you have a question or you need something covered again, or you missed a move before we started taping or recording, I'll need to switch. Because by the way, we're not just streaming, they're going to be available on the webpage to reference if you miss it or want to watch it again. Thanks. But anyway, if we've already covered a move that you need covered again, email us, message us, text us, leave a message. Let me know what move it is and we'll cover it again, we'll review it. So no black sashes left behind, even now. Release. And tendon lengthening, we're washing chi soothing method. Exhale. Hold the breath out. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Continue. I'll review the details of the breathing in another class, but for now, just make sure you exhale completely. It's kind of like a sigh. It doesn't have to be real loud. Keep your abdomen firm, but not super tight. I guess firm is just the right word. You don't have to say not tight. Inhale. Exhale, firm out. Last one. When you exhale, stretch through the body a little more. Same thing up. When you exhale, stretch evenly, no strain. Okay. And we're going to continue warming up a little bit with another one of these postures. So if you didn't know that, the tendon lengthening, marrow washing, chi soothing method, they all have great names, is one of 11 Qigong postures, Chen Qigong. And if you haven't heard Qigong, that just means Qi work, basically, like the Gong and Gong Fu. So Qigong is, anyway, they're more focused on health than on martial arts applications, more health, flexibility, and Qi cultivation. And let's do that. That was number 7 out of 11. We'll go back to number 1. So it's called, I think it's called Wuji Stance Qi Guiding Method. And that's just your first posture from the form, which is the commencement thing. So it's just a focus on that one move. Keep a little, make sure the legs are never locked out. Keep a little bend and feel the weight of the body sort of sink and relax down through the legs a little bit. And then Wuji Stance Qi Guiding Method. Inhale. Stretch through the fingers. Keep the elbows and shoulders down. Exhale. This can be done with another breath at the bottom, but we'll just do it like this. Breathe in. Breathe out. I'm going to try to go at a good pace for breath. But everyone's breath differs, so if you need to go your own pace, that's quite all right. And I wouldn't even know. Especially as a beginner Chen stylist, even if you're an advanced something else stylist, keep those fingers stretched as you go through the different motions. See how it affects your body alignment. Inhale. Let's run our 38. We'll go one move past, or maybe up to the move we've covered. Let me see what happens.
Do you mind locking it?
Of course, thank you. All right. From the top. When you practice on your own, I would suggest going even slower than we go in here. But this is a good, we'll go a good pace for maximizing both the slowness and getting through it. Lazy about tying the robe, R-O-B-E. Inhale. Exhale. You can picture the Kung Fu master gathering his robes. Inhale. To get into a low stance. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Hold breath. Six, sealing, four, closing. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Single, whip, inhale. Continue. Moon Warrior Pounds Mortar 2, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. White Crane spreads its wings. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Oblique forward. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Brush knee twist step. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Hidden hand punch. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Good warrior pounds mortar three. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Lean or draping the fists over the body. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Hold breath. Long exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Dragon emerges from the water. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Double hand push. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Fist under elbow. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Whirling wind arms. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. White crane spreads wings. Repeat. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Oblique form. Repeat. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. In. Continue. Exhale. Flash the back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Continue. Exhale. Inhale. Hidden hand punch. single whip.
Inhale. High pat on horse, inhale,
or pat high horse,
continue, exhale, inhale, continue, exhale, inhale, continue,
exhale,
cross form kick, inhale, exhale.
Touchdown, that's the next move that we haven't covered yet.
Let's do, let's see. Okay, so hopefully you're warmed up now. Let's do a little bit of...
Okay.
All right, cross form kick. So that starts from the end of pat high horse. Trying to picture how this will go. If you're doing this at home, you're going to start with your back to me. So we're facing the same way. And then the left pinky is touching the dantian. Stretch fingers, feel rounded and connected through the arm. Have weight about even though your left heel is up. And then it's going to go down, it's like paint the fence, and up. And then turn your right toes in a little bit, turn your left heel in a little bit. Let that turn, both arms will circle clockwise, looks like to you, wrists touch. Both together we'll go counterclockwise, looks like to you, while the left heel turns out. Shift the weight back as you bring the hands back, and then feel the right toes turn out. Let the hands separate and shift forward like you're doing a little tiny low block and palm strike. Rock back, turn to the left, let the fingers trail like they do with your other sort of ward off motions, but it doesn't get to finish. Sink, turn to the right, pivot on the right heel, let the arms come along, shift to the right, and come up with the left knee. All these knees are like knee strikes, up to the groin, stomach, whatever you got. Step out a little bit in front, kind of like oblique form, and settle. Here's where, when I was learning the form, at least, here's where I would mistakenly start oblique, but it's cross form kick. Feel the right wrist come down, and the left come across. Feel the body turn. Feel the left wrist come down, right comes across. Feel the body turn. Let the left spiral around, and then come down with an elbow strike. Turn the left toes in, flip the left hand over, shift to the right, up to the left, sit back on the left. And if there's any questions. That's a little more of this tempo. Slowly. Step out. Here's that circle. I'm exaggerating again. Doesn't do that much, but if you can feel them connect the waist, it'll go. It'll be tight. That's straightforward. Any questions over there?
In general, still the sunken shoulders, sunken elbows feeling.
Wow, very good question. So the question is, in general, do you still do the sink shoulders, drop elbows, and yes. Let's see, I wonder if there's any part of this where that's most obvious. So if you can feel it right here, you might have a little commonality to the other parts, and if you're fine.
smacked right now, but imagine someone's coming around and smacking you. Still sunk shoulders and elbows, and yes, yeah. So yeah.
Yeah, good question.
All right, let's practice that bit together a few times. Even a common mistake, but the only thing I could think of that might be is once I come up, I step back and let the turn with the blade around. And if I do it just with my arm, it might feel like bad in the shoulder. It might feel, with these, there's not much weight out of at the end of it, so it doesn't give you that feedback. But here's like when you first learn it, it might go like this. But with practice, hopefully you can let it whip a little bit, feel the arm relax, and come around. Does that make sense?
Yes.
That's the only thing I can think of for like a thing to work on, right, when you're just learning. Okay, I said we were going to practice. Let's do it two more times together.
Yes, sir.
Preview the next move just for fun. Pivot the feet into a cross stance. Flip the sword over so its point is going to the mirror, to what was to your right now, where you were facing, left-handed prayer position. Step out to a big stance, your weight mostly on the left. And then here's the first one of these. You're going to shift the weight to go 60-40 on the right while simultaneously the arms pop open. And then from the chest too, and
yeah.
And then at the end, it'll be basically horizontal. Same thing in the shoulder and elbow. Yeah, good. Stretch through the fingers, same shoulder. That's good enough. Okay. So I hope you enjoy this form as we go forward. It's a really cool and relatively simple to learn form compared to some Saber forms out there, and really compared to our RFDN form right now. So, let's go. So, let's go through one more time, and then we'll bow out.
Yes, sir. Begin.
Oh, yeah, we just previewed it. Send us questions, comments, suggestions, or just say, hey, I'm watching, and it went like good or bad, or room for improvement, whatever. Any other questions for me?
Okay.
And let's bow out our black sash class. It's all right. We honor the masters who came before us and seek to follow their examples.
Bow to senior head instructors.
Bow to black sash, bow to each other, black sashes.